I have to ask you this. Amir Khan, great fight, highest rating in the history of the United Kingdom, last fight.
Well, I guess so.
There's talk of him fighting Terence Crawford.
It'll be Crawford or it'll be Brook.
One of them, I think, he'll decide
next week. Yeah, you've got Crawford, it has the belt. Brook has the fight the UK fans have wanted for years and years and years and years. So it's like, you can't really win, because if you turn down Crawford, people will say, oh, you're ducking Crawford. Mm. If you turn down Brook, the British fans will never forgive him.
Right.
So, both good fights, both good fights. But for me, if he believes he can beat Brook, I think he should do that and then fight Crawford. Crawford's a very, very difficult fight for anyone.
Yeah.
Anyone. Doesn't matter whether you're
switch hitter.
I agree with Eddie on that one. I think you should fight Brook first, especially after Brook's last performance with Rafa.
Yeah.
He showed some holes. And I tell you this, Khan has the ability and the talent to beat anyone on any given day.
That's true.
It just depends on how long he can keep up what he does. If he finds his rhythm and has his style going and does what he does best, he does better than anybody in the world.
Looking at Brook's last performance,
Khan beats that guy.
Khan's speed
would
cause major problems
that night.
For Brook.
That's true.
But I do think that was a flat performance from Brook.
Every night's different.
And everybody's entitled to a bad day.
Yes.
Because Kell Brook-Katia was his off night, but he came back after a long time, and sometimes the opponent...
It might have helped him get the fight.
That's true, because he looked vulnerable.
That's exactly what I said while I was watching. He's going to get that Khan fight now.
Exactly.
I think it's a great fight either way. Hopefully the best Khan shows up, the best Brook fight. Khan shows up, we have an amazing fight. And then the Terence Crawford fight is a tough fight, but I agree with Eddie. I think that he fights Brook first, and then if he beats him, gets past him, goes Crawford.
1 week from tonight, Wyatt Chisora, what can you tell him?
Next week's going to be a war.
They don't like each other.
No, they don't.
And it's not fake.
The thing is with those guys is, I've never met two guys who are literally ready to go. Like, you know, fighters are fighters, but these guys, they would go like that. So they could be over there, and they're just having the time of their life. And all of a sudden, something comes and it's like, boom.
Snap.
But that's the fighter. You know, that's like, some people are like, oh, no. No
sure,
trouble.
Yeah.
These guys are just okay. And the problem for Dillian White is he's got a lot to lose because he's built himself up to a very high position.
Almost a Joshua fight,
but he can't resist having a war. Like, he should box clever in that fight, but he's not going to be able to because Chisora's going to put it on him. The only way Chisora can win is to get him into a dogfight and trade up, and you know.
I got my fingers crossed for a dogfight.
Yeah,
I like Dillian White. I like him to fight too.
He's a fighting man.
His brother's cool too.
He doesn't shirk any challenge. Chisora's cool, but you know, like, the difference between them is Chisora is like one of those guys that flicks a switch, where White is always like that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Like, you could be talking to Chisora and you just say one word that just sits in his head and goes, like, I don't know, it might be like, I don't know. You could say to him, "Look at him, mate. Just like, what are those shoes? They're terrible." And I don't know, like, his mum bought them for him or something. And he would just go, "Would you say about my shoes?" It's like, oh, fuck.
Now, Eddie, you've done something in boxing we've never seen at this level, where you sell out stadiums, 90,000, 89,000. How do you do it? Because here in the US, we've never seen it.
It's a different mentality. It's a different culture. You can't just come over and, you know, say to America and go, I'll sell out stadiums in the UK. We're going to do it here.